Hey everyone, in this tutorial we're going to take a look at animating your Unreal MetaHuman characters using ActorCore and Unreal Live Link for iClone. If you're unfamiliar with Unreal Live Link, please check out our other tutorials for an introduction on how to install and use it. You can find the relevant files on the website shown here, which is also linked in the description. The naming convention for MetaHuman characters has gender, height, weight, and body in that order. In MetaHuman, you can see that there are currently three different body type sections for short, average, and tall, with each section containing six different body types. You can go through each section to get some examples of the names based on the rules I mentioned before. In order to keep the naming consistent, we followed the same conventions for our iAvatar dummies, which we'll be using later on. In Unreal, we need to make sure that we've imported the respective iClone files for the MetaHuman model we're using first, and then go to our MetaHuman folder and drag the character mesh into the level. From there, we need to open up the actor blueprint and ensure that we have the body mesh selected before continuing on to select Use Animation Blueprint. This will prompt us to choose our respective animation blueprint for our MetaHuman character, which we can find by searching for it. Once we have it selected, we want to open it up and create a Live Link Pose node in order to activate the Live Link feature. This needs to be connected between the Input Pose and Control Rig nodes. Finally, we need to promote our Live Link subject name to a variable. After that's finished, I then want to go into my Characters Event Graph tab and create a Live Link Skeletal Animation component. In that event graph, we then need to add an onLiveLinkUpdated event node. Essentially, what we're going to do is ensure the character is controlled by casting the animation blueprint. From there, I'll bring my body mesh in as a node and connect it to a getAnim instance function. This then needs to be output to the main character anim blueprint, so we need to add a cast to and find that specific anim blueprint. We then need to connect that to a set live link subject name variable. Since we're only going to be working with the body in this tutorial, I'll just go over to the components and duplicate the one for the face. We can then replace face with body in the name in order to reference the body instead. We then want to pipe that into our live link subject name node. Finally, we need to add in a Live Link Setup function at the end. The original body mesh then needs to be piped into the target of that node so we can ensure that we're driving the correct mesh. The last step before we compile is to connect our onLiveLinkUpdated with our cast2 node. There's much more detailed documentation on Unreal's site about all of these functions and variables, but for the purposes of this tutorial, we just want to give you the standard setup without explaining the specific intricacies. Okay, once all of the fun blueprint stuff is finished, then we can head back into iClone and import the corresponding character from our MetaHuman dummy library. It's important to ensure here again that the naming is identical. From there, we'll just enable our Live Link receiving source in Unreal, then open up the Unreal Live Link plugin in iClone and ensure that the link is active. Then in Unreal, you'll need to find the LL Link body subject field and ensure that you select the mesh of the character that you want to control. After that, we're all set up to animate our MetaHuman character. Let's use the ActorCore library in this case, which contains thousands of motions which you can easily download via the Smart Gallery. Once you click and drag them onto your character, you'll see the motions apply right away. In addition to the ActorCore motion library, iClone also contains a number of powerful animation tools. One such tool is the Motion Key Editor, which is used to do frame-by-frame modifications to your motions, or else even create your own from scratch. You can also easily modify hand gestures with this tool as well. You can start off by applying a gesture template from the content library, and then proceed to further customize every small joint and detail using the Motion Key Editor. Another quick and easy way to animate an iClone is by using the Look At feature. As you can see here, you can have your character easily looking at the camera with a single click, and determine whether there is more emphasis only on the eyes, or else the whole head. Your character can also look at any object in your scene, so it's quite easy to just add a dummy object into your scene and move it around in order to determine where your character will be looking, regardless of your animation. There are tons of other iClone motion tools to get into, but that will be for other tutorials. In the next one, we'll take it to the next level and take a look at how you can animate both the body and face simultaneously. That's about it for this video though. Thanks for watching, guys, and as always, be sure to check out our site for regular updates as well as our forums at forum.reallusion.com. I'll see you in the next video.